Hello everyone, Namaskaram. Myself, Mrs. Vinisha, Head of the Department of Psychiatric Nursing, RV College of Nursing. I am here today to discuss something which is happening at this point of time, right? Due to the viral transmission of COVID-19, the people's life has changed. People are unable to cope and we are finding difficulty. I would like to brief out some of the psychological impact which is happening among ourselves, including myself, and how we can come out of this or how we can reduce this burden among ourselves. One of the major distress what we are suffering right now is the stress. The stress factor which we are facing as a result of this epidemic or this pandemic situation, one or other way we are facing different kind of psychological turbulence, which becomes a stress factor for us. The next one is anxiety. Anxiety is nothing but an emotional response to an anticipating future threats. So at this point of time, this anxiety, but we can say that it's not dangerous and it's not to be a worry factor. And it's not wrong also, because a moderate level of anxiety at this point of time is really healthy. But when it goes to beyond the limits and when it goes beyond the barrier, then it becomes an disturbances and it shows up as a different kind of emotional response to you, and it creates an imbalance in your activities of daily living. There it affects you, and then we call it as we need to pay attention to the particular factor. And next point we can say about the fear factor. We are having fear thinking about how the spread of infection, how the life is going to affect in our another 2-3 months, how it is going to happen, how about our life. We are afraid of thinking, because the fear factor will come when we think about the fact of the matter in the future aspects, right? So there it becomes the fear and the anger. So the anger is one of the factors. How do we get angry, or how the anger will produce? It's an output of the emotional response to stress, right? So the undue stress, when it comes and when it goes beyond the limit, it produces out of ourselves as an anger. And we will show this up along with the frustration. So we will be frustrated out of this, and this frustration and anger, what we call it as, it's two sides of one coin, and it comes consequently at this point of time. Next actually is sadness. The sadness is nothing but what we were hearing all those months regarding the statistical the information. This will affect each and every individual. And next one is sleeplessness. How do we get a sleeplessness? The sleeplessness in this kind of this will result as a factor of the preoccupation with the content what we were hearing throughout the day. But this take you to a situation of sleeplessness at night, concerning all other factors. All the next factor is boredom. At this point, actually, we are in a lockdown period and we can't move around as you were doing it before. It's a monotonous pattern of life we are undergoing throughout the day and night, and it continues to the next day and continues to the coming days. And now we know that we are undergoing through the process of psychological disturbances. But we have to come out of this. We should resolve this. So how? There are some tips. So the first one, focus on what you can control. There are some things which you can't control. The widespread epidemic, how it is going to spread across our country, it's a big question. But then too, there are factors which you can control within ourselves. But at the same time, the policies, the procedures, the government rules and regulations, now the practice or the preventive measures are in front of us. It's your responsibility. You have to follow it up to cope up with this situation and to reduce the burden in among ourselves. But at the same time, the things which you can control, you can make and prevent your infection by following the preventive strategies or the practice, you know, the safety or the preventive measures. Next one is you have to accept the uncertainty. Uncertainty is nothing but we are not sure about what is going to happen. But you should understand that the life will take us to the destiny, and you can't even change the destiny. There are something which is waiting in front of you that is not sure about. We call it as uncertainty. So the next thing what you can do, as we all are in a period of home quarantine, in this period what we can do, follow the measures and we stay home and stay safe. Tip number two, or the second tip what you can do to reduce the psychological impact, seek good quality information. At this point, what we can do, reduce or avoid or limit your watching news channels one day, limit the source of information and try to get the good quality information from the professional news organizations. And next, staying with things which make you calm. It purely depends on individual perspective. Individual perspective in what sense I could say? Like it depends on how you are or how you will be able to maintain your stability or peace of mind within you, right? The thing which may give me a peace of mind is my family time and some entertainment within my family and actively involving household chores activities. Practice faith. The next tip is stay connected. At this point, you know, we are physically connected with only our family members who are around us. But at the same time, the other way of connecting, we can always use the technology to talk, you know, the friends and family members and the people around us. We can make calls or chats or video conferencing and the communication tools. And next tip is living the present. How can you live in the present? It depends on how you want to take your life or how you want to carry your life. Just imagine you always preoccupy your mind with thinking about the past, what has already happened in you, what has happened around us. So ultimately what you are gaining, if it is a pleasurable factor, you will be smiling out of it. If it is not pleasurable and it gives you pain, will be depressed and you're sad. At the same time, you tell other aspect what you will be doing. You are thinking about your future. So here, in those two extreme scenarios, what will happen when you're thinking about your past, you're depressed and sad. But at the same time, when you think about your future all the time, it makes you getting more anxious and worry factor in you. So right now, at this point, what you can do is think about your present. You just focus on in front of things which is happening in front of you. Try to be here and try to be here and now. So think about the matter which comes in front of you. You use your sense, be yourself and use your senses. Ultimately, what you will get out of this, you will be optimistic and you will have much positivity in you. Next tip is maintain a regular schedule. Actually, as we all know, human beings needs a regular schedule or a pattern in order to maintain a regularity in his life, right? Keep in your mind the task which you're supposed to do or to how to accomplish on that particular day. Prioritize the task. Start working on it. So once you set a task, maintain the goals, then prioritize the task, start working on it. And next one, have a proper meal timing. And at the same time, spend quality time with your kids, because kids need some kind of creativity. They can't be a monotone of pattern of life of living, cannot be accepted by the kids. So only thing that involve with them in their play activities, change the play things every day. and involved with the physical activities can be in a form of play. Next one, for you, you are giving the time for your family, kids, and whatever you can do. It's all about physical exercise. For us, what will happen? So when you do exercises or physical exercises, when you start doing and working on it, so which accelerate or which increase the production of endorphin, or it's a hormone which helps you to give you a kind of relaxation in you, which feel more you feel more relaxed, which helps you be more happy, and which lessens your pain, and which reduce the hormone called cortisol. It's a stress hormone which comes up in this level as and when you have or produce the stress in you. So this endorphin will help you to reduce all these burdens, and which give you a kind of happiness or the pleasure in you. And at the same time, as a result of this exercise, there are some chemicals also being produced in your brain, which we call it as the dopamine and serotonin. As a result of these chemicals, this gives a pleasurable effect in you, which make you happy. So these are the end result of all these beneficial end of exercise, which take you ultimately to gaining happiness in your mental health as well. Okay, and lastly is sleeplessness. So what you can do, suppose you went to bed and you are unable to get in sleep, get out of the bed, go and sit in a comfortable place, switch on the light, read which is interesting, one magazine or some newspaper, some articles, try to read about it. You start reading about around 20 minutes and 30 minutes, then ultimately you get a kind of sleepiness in you, and try to go and lie down, and you definitely will get a sleep. And along with that, this is summertime, you can have a shower bath, and before going to bed, that also will refresh you and get a better sleep. And when you lie down bed, try to focus on your body, try to relax each and every muscles and in your body, and then you can relax your brain. Then finally you feel that you are completely relaxed from top to bottom. You will be in a relaxed, settled status. This is the right time for you, and you are going to get a sound sleep with all these measures. And I hope this video is give you a helping hand in order to overcome this kind of the turbulence or the difficulty what you are undergoing through. Thanks.